What's going on, everyone? Scamman87 here, back with another video. Today we're going to take a look at a cool immersive ground crew mod that will allow you to place personnel at air bases that salute and give directions, adding a level of immersion currently missing inside DCS. So without wasting too much time, let's get into it. So the first thing we're going to want to do is go to this website. I'll include a link in the description so it's easy to follow along. And once we're here, we can see Masoon92's asset pack. Huge shout out to him, because this thing is fantastic. As you can see, we can add a lot more than just ground crew personnel inside airbases. But for the sake of this video, we're just going to stick with the ground crew, how to set up triggers inside the mission editor to animate them and get them working. So we just go down here. I've already donated, so feel free if you'd like. But if not, it's free. Just enter a price of zero and purchase. It'll take us here. We put in our email address. Click on get. And it takes us to this page where you click here to visit our content. Once we're here, it'll send us to a Google Drive where we can download it. Go ahead and do that. And we'll just wait for it to download and then we'll install it. Once it's downloaded, we can go ahead and open it up. And what we want to do is we want to extract this into our saved games tech folder within the mods folder. So we'll go through that. C drive for me, users, your name, save games, DCS, mods. If you don't have a mods folder, go ahead and make one. In that mods folder, we want to have a tech folder. So same thing, if you don't have a tech folder, just make one. Extract it into there. For me, because I already have it, it's asking me to override, but you guys, it'll just throw right in. So that's it. It is installed. Let's go ahead and open up DCS and see if it worked. So we're back in DCS in the mission editor. For this example, I've chosen Ellis, but you guys can place it wherever you'd like. I'll add an aircraft into a hangar here. I pick the F-15. Take off from parking hot. Now for the personnel, we're going to want to go into ground units. Infantry, and in our infantry list under type, we should have the personnel crouch worker, the personnel giving in directives, and the personnel salute. So for now, we'll select the salute. We'll put him just off to the side a little bit, make sure he's facing the right way. We do have the option of a few different liveries or variations, and we'll just stick with variation one. Now under here, we're going to want to do advanced waypoint actions. This is to get him to actually salute. We're going to add. We're going to go to set option, alarm state, a red state, condition, is user flag. We'll make this 2, any number you'd like. We're going to add another one for option. Alarm state, green, is user flag, 3. And what we've done here is we've given it the red state is the animation to give up and do the salute, and the green state is to bring him back down to at ease. We'll do that for the salute, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to add the guy giving directions. Same thing, ground units. This time, we're going to switch it to giving directions or directives. We'll place him. Same thing, make sure he's facing the right way. We also have variations for him as well. And we'll switch him up, give him a purple belt. We're going to do the same thing we just did for the salute. Options, alarm state, red state, condition, is user flag. This time, we're going to make him different flag numbers than the other guy. So for him, we did 2 and 3. We did red 2, green 3. So for this one, we'll do red 4. We'll add. Alarm state is our green because we just did the red. And we'll say this is 5. Get rid of that. See, he's got 2. Oh, that one didn't look like it didn't take. If you don't have the question mark beside it, it means you didn't add the condition. So we'll edit that. Condition And we can see I didn't click that to make that 3. With question marks. Same thing for him. I didn't click that box. Edit it. Condition. Is user flag. Oh, the green state. Is user flag 5. That's set up. That's set up. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to add our triggers. And what we want is we want two triggers. We want a trigger about here. When this F15 travels through it, it'll give him his command. And we'll do a trigger here for the direction. So when he travels through that, it'll give him his command. So we're going to go to our triggers. Here, we'll shrink this as low as we can. I believe it's 16. We'll change that to salute. Slur, salute. And we'll add another one here. Same thing, we'll shrink it. And we'll call this direction. So we've got two triggers made. Let's go ahead into the advanced part and activate all these triggers. So set rules for trigger. Gonna have a new trigger. Once, doesn't matter the event. I'm going to go down here. Unit inside zone. Aerial 1-1. And the zone that we want is salute for the first one. With that, we're going to add an action. We're going to click flag on. And the flag that we want to turn on is 2. We're going to add another trigger. This time, we're going to use time since flag. Flag 2. And for his salute, we'll say his salute will last about 5 seconds. So what that means is when he goes to salute, flag 2, 5 seconds later, we're going to use this to turn on flag 3, which will bring him down back to Eddie's. So now we've set up the salute. We're going to go ahead and we're going to set up the direction. So a new trigger. Same thing as we did. Unit entering zone or unit inside zone. Aerial 1-1, this time direction. Give him a new task. Action, flag on. This time we're going to make the flag 4 for this guy. Same thing, we'll add another one. Time since flag. This time it's going to be flag 4. Same thing as before, we'll make it 5 seconds. The action again will be flag on. This time flag 5. Bringing the guy that's giving directions at ease. So if we go through it again, this trigger, inside zone, turn on flag 2. This one, once flag 2 goes on, 5 seconds, turns on flag 3. The F-15 gets into the zone of direction, turns on flag 4. Time since flag 4 is 5 seconds, turns on flag 5. Let's go ahead inside and see if this worked. We've loaded up that mission we just made. Let's see if everything works. Giving him a salute. 5 seconds, you should drop it. There's his direction. 5 seconds, you should go back to normal. Nice. That's it, guys. Of course, you're going to have to tinker with it a little bit to get it to your specific needs. But that's just a rough idea of how you can set up the assets from this asset pack. And like I said earlier, there is definitely a lot more. There's some movable vehicles, different bunkers, ammo boxes, crates, and all that kind of stuff. So that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, please like and subscribe, and have yourselves a great day and a great weekend. Take care.